Welcome to day two of our two-day digital short play festival at the 6th South Asian Theatre Festival. Hope you all enjoyed a wonderful Saturday immersed in watching plays, feeding your brain and soul with the arts. In a time of crisis, the role of art becomes very central to our lives, whether we realize it or not. Art can set us free. Even in restriction, art offers us a chance to be mobile, to move around freely in a fictional world in a way that is now quite impossible in reality. Art connects us to the foreign, to the exotic, and the impossible. But in our current context, it also connects us to a world where anything is possible. Keeping the art alive requires a twofold approach. Support cultural professionals and institutions, and promote access to art for all. Spotlight Columbus follows both the approaches. In our quest to create a cultural community, even in this restrictive environment, Spotlight Columbus has strived to bring to your home a variety of talents from all across the globe, presenting their short plays digitally under the proud banner of the 6th South Asian Theatre Festival. To present day two, we have another very special guest. She's a playwright, author, director, producer, actress, poet, songwriter, mime dancer, and the founder of Mime for God Productions, LLC. She's also a founder of the Columbus Black Theatre Festival, held every year in the second week of July in Columbus, Ohio. Julie is very special to Spotlight Columbus, not only because she was a panelist in our 5th South Asian Theatre Festival, but also because Julie was there in the audience from the moment the 5th annual South Asian Theatre Festival started till the very end and watched every single production in that festival. Besides being a theater enthusiast, Julie is an ordained minister, a mother, and a grandmother. It is my honor and privilege to present to you Miss Julie Whitney Scott.
Welcome to the second day of the 6th annual South Asian Theater Festival. I'm Julie Whitney Scott, the founder and artistic director of Mime for God Productions and the Columbus Black Theater Festival. This year has been challenging for everyone, especially the theater world, as we continue to bring quality theater performances to our audiences due to COVID-19 and state social distancing guidelines for safety, which we respect and abide by. With that being said, I want to congratulate Spotlight Columbus Inc. Company for presenting their 6th annual South Asian Theater Festival 2020 as a digital streaming event. Spotlight believes that the South Asian Theater Festival enriches the community and engages diverse community members towards a common goal. Spotlight continues to meet their goals of promoting theater arts in the greater Columbus area and Franklin County areas, promoting diversity and inclusion in Central Ohio, and addressing social issues through theater and panel discussions. They emphasize collaborations among diverse communities and diverse community artists to engage, educate, and showcase the strength and energy of South Asian culture. Spotlight acts as an advocate for marginal voices by creating opportunities for non-English playwrights, speakers, and performers to be heard in the Midwest. And the festival has been attended by intimate theater personalities from around the world in the past. South Asian Theater Festival has become a vibrant addition to the cultural landscape of Greater Columbus and received the Central Ohio Theater Roundtable 2019 Herald Award for their festival. The past 5 years, 2015 to 2019, have included plays in both South Asian native languages with English subtitles and English. They have involved local theater personalities to both teach and act in the plays presented. Each year, they also present a panel discussion based on the theme for the year, which includes theater personalities internationally and locally known as panelists and moderators. I had the honor of being a panelist on the 2019 Breaking the Glass Ceiling panel discussion and on this year's Is This Pandemic Changing Theater in the Future? And What Will Be the Place of Theater in the Future? Panel discussion. The South Asian Theater Festival 2020 presents plays from playwrights, directors, and actors from Chicago, North Carolina, Washington, D.C., Georgia, New Jersey, and of course, Ohio. I'm looking forward to watching, enjoying, learning about South Asian culture and appreciating the wonderful creative work presented coming to life on stage in a digital way. Please join me in congratulating Spotlight, Columbus & Company, playwrights, directors, actors, and technical support team on their presenting the second day of the 6th annual South Asian Theater Festival 2020. Congratulations, and thank you for continuing to bring theater, quality, thought-provoking theater to Central Ohio. I'm Julie Whitney Scott, Mind for God Productions, Columbus Black Theater Festival. Stay safe, stay well, God bless.
Our next guest is an actor, producer, director, and professor at the Columbus State Community College, teaching theater and communications. He was also the director of the Columbus National Gay and Lesbian Festival through 2006. He received the prestigious OOBR Award for Outstanding Off-Broadway Play of his production, The Members of the Tribe. He was also a panelist for our panel discussion at the 4th South Asian Theatre Festival. Let me present to you Frank Barnhart.
Hello, everyone. I'm Frank Barnhart, an associate professor of theatre at Columbus State, and I will be one of your panelists this year for the South Asian Theatre Festival 2020. This year, it is all digital. It's going to be great. Congratulations on another year in Columbus and for bringing such wonderful theatre to our city.
Hello, everybody. Namaskar. Namaste. I hope you enjoyed yesterday's show. Today is the last day of the South Asian Theatre Festival 2020. As I told yesterday, I am known as Prabal Basu. I live in Columbus. My special thanks to Julie Whitney Scott and Frank Barnhart for their unparalleled support to the Spotlight and South Asian Theatre Festival 2020. Yesterday, some of you may not get chance to watch the shows. That's why I am repeating today that I am involved with the Spotlight since almost beginning. And since then, I have acted in a couple of plays under the direction of the renowned directors of India. Today, I don't want to spoil your valuable times because lots of excitement or theaters are waiting for you. My best wishes to the cast and crews and Spotlight and South Asian Theater Festival 2020. Today, we are going to show again last 5 years' journey of the Spotlight through the video clips, and which is prepared by Chaurav Rai Chaudhuri. Sit down, lean back, relax, and enjoy the theater. See you again. Stay safe. Thank you.
In early 2015, a group of passionate theater enthusiasts came together to open a theater group in Columbus, Ohio called Spotlight. The broad goals were promotion of theater arts in Greater Columbus and Franklin County, promotion of diversity and inclusion in Central Ohio through a year-long programming, and addressing social issues through theater and panel discussions. The theme of our first South Asian Theater Festival in 2015 was celebrating the power of womanhood, and it featured, among other things, two acclaimed plays from Afghanistan and India. Sitara was acted by Monira Hashemi and directed by Leif Pearson.
You can either take a life with a word to someone, but I don't want my life for you. After stoning me to death, throw the stones, throw.
The home production by Spotlight was Bajbhumi, or The Hurt Stone, directed by the legendary theatre director and actor from India, Meghnad Bhattacharya. Spotlight act as an advocate for marginalized voices by creating opportunities for non-English playwrights, speakers, and performers to be heard in the Midwest heartland of the United States. 2016 was a second year of our highly successful South Asian Theater Festival, and it featured two plays, a musical drama, and a panel discussion. The home production was a Bengali play, O.R. Kokho, or The Enlightenment, which was directed by the famed theatre playwright and director Meghnad Bhattacharya from India. The play was acted by local talents from Columbus, Ohio.
Our director, Meghnad Bhattacharya.
The festival also featured the Masrayana by the ICS Theatre Group and was directed by Mahesh Dattani.
Scene 20, in which Mr. Masra is awakened by a notion.
Mrs. Havakur.
Mr. Masra, it's only a thunderstorm.
It's not a storm that woke me.
What is it?
You must go find your friend.
Sita, Draupadi, Mirabai, Rani of Chansi, and Chittarangana.
The dance drama titled The Woman of Virtue was performed by Kaustavi Sarkar and local talents from Columbus, Ohio. The last event for 2016 was a panel discussion on theater for social justice. The 2017 edition of the South Asian Theater Festival was organized by the Spotlight Columbus and featured three plays and a panel discussion.
দেখে মজা লাগলো ব্যাস দাঁড়িয়ে পড়লাম।
In 2017, the home production for Spotlight was The Woman of Manto. This was a compilation of three stories by the famous playwright Sadat Hasan Manto, and this was directed by the famous Indian theater director, actor, and activist Usha Ganguly. The play was performed by the local talent from Columbus, Ohio. The English drama, Our Voices, was written by Gargi Mukherjee and produced by Cat.
It was the most amazing experience of my life.
The play was directed by Andrew Protopapas. The third play was an English drama titled The Genes of Edgar, performed by Epic Workers Workshop, New Jersey. The panel discussion was on social challenges portrayed in theater. In 2018, the South Asian Theatre Festival organized by Spotlight featured three plays and a panel discussion. The home production for Spotlight in 2018 was Ochin Dosho, or The Unlikely Companion. It was directed by the famous actor-director from India, Dev Shankar Halda, and it was performed by the local talent from Columbus, Ohio. The festival also featured a Bengali play called Gubudanga by the Michigan Literary and Theatre Society of the Millets.
That was very badly. Shita, come on.
Jogin's biggest problem with our little bugger.
Catco presented an English play called The Elephant in the Room, which was directed by Joe Beshara and co-directed by Andrew Protopapas, and was written and acted by Priyanka Shetty. The topic for panel discussion was Life is Theatre. In 2019, South Asian Theatre Festival organized by Spotlight was a mega event. It featured a Bengali play, Ronangon or Warfront, performed by the Michigan Literary and Theatre Society, or MILETS. The next play was a Hindi play with English supertitles called Akbari Lota, or Storytelling. It was performed by Mandy Theatre Group from Chicago, Illinois. The home production was Mrityu Na Hatta, or An Accidental Death of an Anarchist. This was a Bengali play with English supertitles and performed by Spotlight Columbus. The play was directed by Partho Pratim Deb, a famous playwright and director from India.
cooking too. After that, I said, look, they got a
nephew. Please, you know what the word is, super cool.
Amina, a bomber driver, but a bow.
The Epic Actors Workshop performed Nirast, or the Unarmed.
Make a knock. Sir!
The second day attractions was Tom Paine, a play by Catco Columbus.
One of us walks away.
Now imagine a pink glove. I was lucky in it once. I was left by now.
Journey Towards Light, an English musical performed by Kaleidoscope, Columbus, Ohio. The final play was Chekhov Express, performed by the ICS Theatre Group, New Jersey. In year 2020, after 5 years of hosting the South Asian Theatre Festival in Columbus, Ohio, Spotlight was presented with prestigious Harold Award for bringing multilingual dramas and showcasing the South Asian culture in the United States. The Harold Award is named in honor of the late Harold Eisenstein, a theatre director who led the gallery players for decades. We at Spotlight are and have been a performing art organization with primary mission to organize, promote, and participate in high-quality theater art, stage drama, musical drama, as well as to provide a platform for expert panel discussions on theater. An emphasis here is to put on collaborations among diverse community artists to engage, educate, and showcase the flamboyance and vibrance of South Asian culture in the United States.